As it was in the early years of the Elks organization, so it is today. The spirit of giving. Beginning in 1953, this common thread of giving, which has been shared by hundreds of Elk members in our community, has formed the fabric by which our South Kingstown Lodge number 1899 has been woven. The following collection of short movies was filmed and produced in 2016, 2017, and 2018 with a purpose of capturing the voices, smiles, and laughs of our members and friends, and to record a period in time when we all joined together to achieve our mission of giving. We hope you enjoy this part two of an Elks Time Capsule anniversary film. Hi, Rod.
Hey.
Doing this again?
Once again. This is for the heating assistance fund at the Elks here. We help families pay for their heating oil if they're unable to fill their tank. We fill it for them.
Beautiful. Who's this guy right here next to you?
That's Todd Evans.
Yeah. How you doing? What's going on? You've done this for quite a few years, haven't you?
Oscar Sisson. The video on the screen, it's sword fishing on the Rowan.
Okay.
And the footage is from 1972.
Hello.
Hi, Carrie. How are you?
Potatoes tonight.
Very nice.
This is Annie's breakfast dinner, and you can get in if you give me some money.
I will give you some money. Well, okay. Thank you. Are you asking everyone for money, or do they have tickets?
Everybody has to have some money.
Well, what are you doing hiding behind Billy Forbes?
Here, I got one more.
Have you guys bartended this event before?
Yes, we have.
A few times.
Oh, very good. Thank you very much for all that you do.
We love it to do this one.
Beautiful. How many swordfish have you cooked up so far?
We're about 125 right now.
Wow.
Yeah, it is. Every year we usually get fish donated, or sometimes we have to buy them, but every year it turns out we make a couple $1,000 anyway for heating assistance. It really helps some people out there.
So we've got a good crowd so far. We usually raise, we're hoping for a couple $1,000.
Wow. And all for heating assistance?
This is all for heating.
All for heating assistance.
Rod's a really good man. Someone told me today, over the course of his career, he's donated or raised $1 million towards charity. I don't know. I believe it. But he is the best, and he's very humble, and I love him.
Thank you so much for all that you do, too.
Hi, we're Susan and Bill Goff from Wakefield, Rhode Island.
Congratulations, Lodge 1899.
So hi, I'm Joe Kozierik. I'm the chairman of our Lodge 1899 Hoop Shoot. The Hoop Shoot's a great program. It introduces young folks to the Elks Lodge and what we do. It's a free throw shooting contest for boys and girls, three divisions each, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12 and 13 years old. It's a national program, so as they go through the lodge and through the district and through the state, the winners move on. Once they get to the state level, their expenses are paid by the Elks. Their lodging and their travel and all their meals. The winners that come out of the district and from the state will go to the regional up in Maine, and they'll shoot for a chance to go compete in Chicago. We have great volunteers here at our lodge. Last year we had about 20 volunteers at the event. So we run a lodge hoop shoot and then the district hoop shoot, and they move on from there.
Okay, that big trophy that's there, that is the Daniel C. Watson Trophy. Danny was a member of the South Kingstown Elks for many, many years. He got me involved in the hoop shoot for almost 30 years ago. He was our state hoop shoot director for many, many years. We were all very fortunate to consider him a friend. He passed away last February, so we named that trophy in his honor. So that's for the high score.
The winner in Chicago get their name on a plaque that goes into the Naismith Basketball Hall of Fame. which is pretty cool. So, you know, how many kids get an opportunity to have their name up in the Basketball Hall of Fame. But it's a great event. It gives everyone a chance to compete. And there's some great talent. It's these guys that move on. They shoot 10 free throws, take a break, and shoot 15 more free throws. So there's a total of 25 free throws. They're hitting 23, 24 free throws. It's a ball, though. It's a great event for the kids.
Hold up the trophy, she said. Hold them up. Be proud.
It's a great event for the volunteers to be able to do that for our community. So come check it out.
Happy 65th anniversary, South Kingstown Elks.
My name is Jeff Robert. I'm a past exalted ruler of this lodge, South Kingston Lodge number 1899.
How are you guys doing? You enjoying this tonight?
Oh, we love this.
There's nowhere else I'd rather be.
Excellent. Beautiful. What do you got?
We got prime rib, three baked stuffed shrimp, baked potato, and green beans.
Nice. Any dessert?
What could you want?
Yes, there's a chocolate vanilla cake and coffee.
Beautiful.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. We're enjoying it.
Thank you,
on this.
I'm not kissing this beard, okay?
No.
I can't say enough about the volunteers that we have, the house committee that did the bulk of the work, and all the other volunteers that jumped in to serve. Everybody's smiling or whatever. And that is the actual plating of the meal going out that day. That's what we look like when we do what we do. It's a well-oiled machine. One of the most awesome things for me, the things that we do, just to brighten everybody's day in our community as best we can. This place does it with over-the-top participation. The volunteers we have here are just phenomenal. There's a full room, band set up to play later. Just a surf and turf dinner. Break out the little February doldrums. You know, and this is what we do on a regular basis. And we look forward to having you come join us.
Hi, I'm Bob Cruz. I just want to say happy 65th birthday to the South Kingston Elks, 1899.
Okay, today, February 25th, 2017, our annual venison dinner. I'm Rodman Sykes, James Nelson here. He's going to tell you where the deer came from.
Right, a good part of the deer came from Lock Island. Local areas in South Kingstown and Charlestown. A lot of the deer from the island were in a program to eradicate a lot of the deer due to Lyme disease and overpopulation. And we felt like we're doing some family and friends out there somewhat of a favor by going out there and harvesting deer on the island.
Now on the menu today we have, tell what we got, James.
Well, we're gonna start off with a venison cabbage soup, which is a very big favorite of a lot of people. And Jerry Gardner has made a great venison stew, and that will be somewhat of the first course. And then we will be going into a venison stroganoff with venison lasagna that comes with a salad that we're gonna put out. And then we will have our main course, which is venison roasts with roasted potatoes, green beans, and pretty much that's about it. Yep, we have a surprise guest today. It's one of our great friends from Block Island. His name is Richard Miles Stinson. He's one of the people that incorporate and get the permission for us to go hunting on the island. And he's been a local guide on the island for us for many years. And we owe much of our success to Richard Miles Stinson.
Yeah, he was part of the team that started this. These game dinners and venison dinners started down in Galilee. Back then it was for the benefit of the Fisherman Scholarship Fund down there. Probably 30 years ago, as some of the other fishermen retired, and James and I kind of took it over, and we've kept it going. It's just a venison dinner. We don't have any of the ducks and geese and squirrels and rabbits that they used to have, but so we leave those animals alone. We just get the deer. I think it'll be a profitable night for Elks Charities.
Awesome.
Elks Care, Elks Share.
Perfect company. We love the Elks. We love everyone here. Community. We love you guys.
This is Sally Dwarsick saying happy anniversary, Lodge 1899, for your 65th year.
Once we figure out how many people we have coming, we put together a kitchen crew. And Russ Mason, who is our kitchen manager, supervises the cooking of the meal. The last meal was a pork loin. And we always have the same people that show up to help out just because they enjoy being in the kitchen. And you'll see Jack Casey there every single time without fail. Russ's wife, Patty, is always there by his side. Walter Campbell was involved in this at one point. I would have to say I rely very much on Bob Whitten. Bob and his wife, Mary, are right by my side every time we do something. In fact, we're actually probably co-chairs of this committee. I would look at it that way. He's constantly there to help out. So he does a lot of the background work. We had two new members volunteer to come over and give us a hand with the card tournament. The brother and sister team, Amanda Westfell and Phil Fell.
Our Elks Lodge, we love it. Excellent. Anything we can do to help.
What a wonderful event tonight. Milo Jack tournament, yes.
Most people really aren't very serious about it. They're there to have a good time and to meet some new friends. So it's a different kind of a tournament. We have a card that's set up. We play 40 hands. People raise their hand. I have several people throughout the hall that have hole punchers in their hand. They come over, the team tells them what they got. They just punch a hole in the specific area of that card. After four hands, I blow a whistle.
When the whistle blows, the teams with the even numbers.
And everybody now changes partners.
Early celebration! Oh.
It's a different kind of a tournament, and it's surprising how quickly it really does go. Within about an hour to an hour and 15 minutes, we've played 20 hands. At the end of the tournament, we tally up the scores. So we start working backwards until we finally get to somebody who has gotten 88 or 87 points or whatever it may be. Then we take that card and verify it. And if in fact they did get that number, they're awarded whichever prize is available.
My name is John Rose, been a member of South Kingstown Elks for 36 years. Congratulations on your upcoming birthday.
The installation of officers for 2017-2018 was to bring our new exalted ruler, Mary Atzert, on board. The installation is performed by the suite of officers from the West District of the State Elks Association. They are presented along with other visiting Elk members prior to the actual installation ceremony. Once it begins, the chairman of the West District then presides over the actual installation. He then introduces each member, which includes the officers, the trustees, and others in appointed positions, all to be led by the incoming exalted ruler, Mary Atzert. District Deputy Robert Schulder then issues the oath of office to the incoming officers and trustees. He then installs each officer in their position, the last being the exalted ruler. After a few words from outgoing exalted ruler Jeff Robert, there are further presentations.
The trustees, everybody's been working really hard. This thing's coming together.
Here we see our House Committee and many of our volunteers, along with Wakefield Boy Scout Troop Number 1, turning the hall into a beautiful dining area. The room is transformed within minutes. And so we embark on another year of good deeds and charitable works.
Yay!
Hi, I'm Mary Terminese, and I want to say happy 65 years, South Kingstown Elks.
Senior night has become extraordinarily popular with our seniors.
Hey, got all these people coming in, want to make it look pretty.
We needed to look at different revenue streams for the support of charity endeavors. we came upon the Community Investment Program. The Community Investment Program is run by the Elks National Foundation. It has four different grants that it provides to the various lodges that represent programs that they will approve that go to support various activities in our community. The Beacon Grant is a $2,000 grant that we applied for 4 years ago for the support of honoring our seniors. And we went to the center and we discussed what we wanted to do. We got the grant and that's what kicked off that program. And what's so great about that program is today we just had our fifth dance in April. So we get 150 seniors, we do the dinner, we deliver 50 to the homebound.
And this is really one of the first, if not the first event, kicking off Order Americans Month, which is in the month of May.
Hello everybody. On behalf of the Elks, I'd like to thank you all for coming. It's glad to see the faces year after year. Just keep on coming.
We go to our businesses in our community who are extraordinarily generous.
The centerpieces, as every year, you know, it's hard to beat Belmont's. They are always there when you ask.
I know this event has been going on here for 5 years, and I've been to every one of them as I am in my third term at the town council. But the town council would like to welcome each and every one of you here.
Yeah, I just got down from delivering over at Indian Run. We delivered 50 meals.
How many meals?
50.
Wow, cool.
Everybody was very thankful for the Elks, and they really enjoy it. They talk about it all the time. The bus driver even said for about the next couple weeks, they're going to keep talking about it.
We have absolutely no difficulty in getting volunteers from our lodge to do it. Our members love that program.
Hi, this is Stephen King, alias Tweet. I want to say happy birthday to the Elks, and they do a tremendous job in the community of Wakefield, Rhode Island. Keep it up, Elks.
Well, craft beer is made by folks that started, most of them start brewing in their own homes, okay, and it gets a little bigger, and somebody says, hey, this is really good, you should make more of it, and it brings its way up from that into a microbrew type of thing. And just so you know the difference between a microbrew and say a big beer house like Budweiser, Anheuser-Busch, they make a lot of beer. The craft brews and the microbrews, they usually judge based on 15,000 barrels or less. So if you're under that, then that is your official label.
Dave is very knowledgeable about the craft beer. When we go in to speak to a brewer, he's the front man. He's the one that will talk about the beer as far as the flavors. And when we go in, we smell the beer, you know, we taste it. Then at that point, it's a matter of pitching what we're doing. A lot of our volunteers help us at the actual tasting. Because Dave and I pretty much go and do all the legwork. And they come in and they'll help us set up. They'll help us pour the beer. They'll help us break down at the end of the night. That's where the volunteers come in. It seems as we've progressed through the last 3 years, we're getting more and more volunteers coming on board to help us out.
Jim's really well organized. When we get to actually having the craft beer tasting, he's all over. I think we complement each other pretty well for what we're doing.
There we go.
Woo! Nice.
Hi, my name is Noah Sullivan. I've been an Elk for 7 years, and happy birthday, Elks 1899.
Home Wrap is really a very interesting event here at the Lodge and stands for Home Maintenance and Repair Assistance Program. For small repairs, painting, yard work, those sorts of things. And what we thought would be something that would really be important to this community was the program that we finally decided on, and that was this Home Maintenance Repair Assistance Program, or what's called an impact grant. part of the community investment program supported by the Elks National Foundation. And the reason that they called it that was they wanted to approve programs offered by lodges that have a significant impact upon their community. We thought this is the program that you guys are actually looking for. Made the submission. Lo and behold, we were one of 20 lodges nationally that received an impact grant in 2014, I think it was.
All right, right about there.
And what we were hoping to accomplish is really get the lodges brand out in the community. This is what the Elks is all about. We're volunteers. We're out here, hopefully, making the lives of those that we live with better.
They're the most energetic over-the-hill guys I've ever met. So what I really like is when they laugh all together.
That's a great picture.
Hey, I'm free!
That's awesome.
I'm free! Free!
Happy 65th anniversary, Lodge 1899, CC Allwood, Elks member. Yes!
Hi, I'm John Foreman, member of the South Kingston Elks Lodge. I've been a member now for 14 years. I'm proud to be so. One of the reasons why I love being an Elk is because we are always able to help people in need. For example, I came home one night and saw the news, and they had shown a family that had had a house fire. It just happened to be that we had a meeting that night. I came to the meeting and explained to the members that there was a family just had a house fire with their 7 kids, and we need to do something to help them. Everyone says, yes, we're going to help. Committee was formed that night. It was spontaneous, like we always do around here.
One of my good friends, Sonny.
And within 5 weeks, we were able to do a fundraiser to donate money for them. All we had to do is put in a word to the Boy Scouts that we sponsor here. We're having this fundraiser. Can you please help us out? Without hesitation, they said yes. That was great to see them here in their uniforms and helping us put the food out, the cleaning up. So that was great. Meanwhile, we had gotten the tickets printed up, free of charge. Raffle tickets donated to us from the community business people. They always pitch in whenever we ask them to help.
Isn't this a beautiful cake?
The Job Corps brought us down a huge cake to use for dessert for that event. And it just goes on and on. We were able to have a spaghetti dinner, which was sold for a reasonable price, and yet able to still sustain a large donation of over $3,000 for this family. This is the way that we can make great strides for this community and for this lodge. So we're proud about doing that.
My name is Marilyn Hamilton. Happy birthday, South Kingston Elks.
This is a traditional Italian recipe. It came into being to get longer use out of the overripe tomatoes at the end of the season. The mixture that we're preparing has balsamic vinegar in it, which works as a preservative, allowing the tomatoes to be stored at room temperature for up to 10 days.
If they had told you the ingredients, he'd have to kill you.
Yeah,
I was doing well.
Yeah. Well, not only that, none of that stuff I told him is true. I made that up.
Well, Italian Night came about, we needed a fundraiser, and we needed one that was kind of off season and inside. We had enough events outside and we had enough events in the warmer months, but they wanted something that would go on in either in the winter or early in the spring. And we had just done an Irish night at my parish. And that was the inspiration to start an Italian night.
know, ground parmesan.
Okay, yeah.
Spices and mayonnaise all mixed up together.
Whole garlic, I got it over here. Sounds like riding a horsey.
Lynn. Okay, yeah.
John Foreman, another past exalted ruler, sets the bar for Elkdom in volunteerism and a sense of responsibility and charity, and I'm proud to call him my friend. And this night on Italian night with our bartenders is quite special.
What we're celebrating tonight is good food, fine friends, and companionship, which is native to the Italian culture, but not exclusive to it. The same thing happens when people who understand life and appreciate life gather. That's what tonight is about. To all of you who are here tonight, thank you. Abundanza. Nikki.
Being that Italian night is centered around the food, there is no entertainment other than my short speeches. We wanted it to be special. We didn't want someone to stand up and say, dinner's ready, the buffet line is open, come and eat. We wanted it to have a specific beginning that meant something. To kick it off with some drama, we went to the great Italian composer Rossini and took from his famous group of overtures.
Baby, how are you doing, brother?
You're doing good, yeah, man. Good job.
These people have been working for 3 days. What is anything? Just to come here tonight and make tonight a success.
Events of the night should be like a family dinner. Yes, it's a fundraiser. Yes, it's in the Elk Hall. And when things are right and we're all moving in the same direction, the Elks are like a family.
I'm Tom O'Rourke, and I've been a member of the Elks for 45 years. Happy anniversary.
On the surface, the dedication of space seems so arbitrary. Four walls, ceiling, foundation, they're just simple, ordinary objects. That begs the question, why? Why do we dedicate? Why are these ceremonies so meaningful? The truth is that it can't be portrayed with just one word, one definition. It is much too deep to limit it to just scratching the surface.
Exalted ruler, I present to you, as a representative of the Grand Lodge, dedication plaque, which will be hung above the entrance to our lodge hall.
A lodge esquire, you will proclaim the dedication of this lodge hall in the memory of our absent brother and deliver this plaque to the board of trustees of this lodge that it may be hung in a position of honor.
By and in accordance with the order of the lodge board, I declare this lodge dedicated to the memory of Walter Louis Elton, in the name of Jerry Elton.
Walter believed in our obligation. I believe in our obligation. I hope all of you do also. In our obligation, we speak of brotherly love. This is the part of brotherly love. This is an expression of it. This is the essence of it. Today's a day of celebration and of living our obligation.
Walter, in all his years as an Elk, have influenced and helped so many Elks in this great association.
Up until his recent illness, Walter was always still in the hoop shoot, but he also cared and shared with all his lodges.
And he was also the highest ranking Elk in Rhode Island. And he was the recipient of the Presidential Award for Volunteering in 2010. Because it's rare that we see a man who gives so much to his community and to the Elks and his family.
Now, therefore, be it resolved that this expression of sorrow for the passing of Walter Dewey Cattell, Jr. is placed upon the records of the town of South Kingstown, and that our deepest sympathy is conveyed to his family.
So on behalf of the Rhode Island State Elks Association, the officers and members, it is my honor to congratulate Judy and her family on this hall being dedicated to Walter, and I wish them all the best.
Well, I would first like to congratulate South Kingston Lodge of Elks, number 1899, for 65 years. Oh my goodness, do I have a tapestry of wonderful memories.
Hello, my name is Bob Whitten.
And I'm Mary Whitten.
And we chaired the cigar dinner for the Veterans Committee.
So Shelly, my recommendation is we start over here and get all that stuff gone.
That's cigar dinner was formed out of committee as a way to do something different at the Elks while raising money for our veterans. Cigar dinners are very popular nationwide, so it was something new to the Lodge, and we're hoping that bringing in something different would encourage more membership and participation from the community. And both the dinners that we've done, we've achieved those results. The cigar dinner, with any event done by the Elks, requires lots of volunteers and lots of coordination. We started about 90 days out, getting a variety of people. It takes about 10 to 12 to put this event together for about 30 to 45 diners. So very labor intensive compared to other Elks events, but it is a bit more of an upscale event.
You couldn't put any kind of set fancy garnish like a restaurant, but you put simple things like this. Simple elegance. Got olive oil, parmesan, it's a little salty, oregano, you can taste it.
Look at that, see that?
I know my timing, huh?
Assume the position.
The green grass of home.
Yeah, wow.
This is where it all happens. Just like Disney, where the magic begins.
And a slowed down event too. A cigar dinner, if it's done right, will last between 3 and 3.5 hours. It's not a real quick dinner.
Cigars!
Oh, very nice. What kind of cigars? Wow, yep, you're going to have those? Oh, very nice. Wow. So this is their process, right?
It's a process. Process.
I never smoked cigars.
And the reason for that, we want everyone to enjoy the food, the wine, and pair it with the cigars. We did have support from the community. Belmont Market was one of our supporters, along with Cigar Box, who gave us the cigars at cost, which was a big savings that helped our end profit.
Just right, Dave. Just
perfect. That's a good effect. That's what I'm looking for. That's what I'm looking for.
Good. You just found it.
So being this was something new, it's garnered people's attention, and we're hoping that will grow as we move down the line.
Steve Rogers from Wakefield, Rhode Island. Happy birthday, Alex 1899.
We'll usually set up a table either out on the deck if the weather's nice. Everyone usually checks in with us, and then they'll find out what tee they on by when they check in.
I notice you don't have a jacket on. That means you're smart.
Captain Sykes.
Yep. Captain Sykes, okay.
Jerry Grandpre, he's 97. He's still here.
Excellent. Have you guys played in this tournament before? Three times?
No. Hell no, it's not going to clear up. It's going to rain like hell in a few minutes.
It never rains on the golf course. Never.
It never rained. It's never stopped. So we played, and it was nasty. We got like 65 people out of 76, I think, that played or something like that. So I give everybody a lot of credit. We stuck it out to the end. So, yeah, there's a lot of camaraderie. So we were on the seventh tee. It's a very large par three green with a lot of undulation on it. Nancy Steinmeier was putting on the green, and she had made this ridiculously long putt. At 60 to 70 feet, it had about maybe 10 feet of break, and it was just an amazing putt to make. After the tournament's done, most of the people will go back to the lodge, and we do our South Kingstown Elk steak fry. Everybody cooks their own with those big kettles, and we eat. And we keep score, we announce the prizes. And then we have some raffles. The tournament benefits the lodge, and it raises money so the lodge can perform more good things around town.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you.
And after all, rain or shine, elks care, elks share.
Congratulations, Lodge 1899.
My name is Mike Pesta. I am one of the people who has been the chairman of the 25-25 committee. It's also included Ken Kennison, Al Early, and Bob and Mary Witten.
This is Bill Minow, and I'm Dick Feldhausen. We're from Knowles Camp now. Nice. Oh, we love this. This is a great charity and great event.
The 25-25 fundraiser was started around 2005 by Al Early. It was a way for the charity committee to raise the funds that they needed to meet the requests and the charitable works that they wanted to underwrite.
It's all living the dream.
Excellent.
Yeah.
You buy a ticket for $25, and then there's a weekly drawing for $25 for 25 weeks.
Attention to all the wait staff in the ballroom.
And then at the end, there's a dinner dance and grand prize drawings of $1,500, $250, $150.
Hello and welcome to the 25-25 Dinner 2017.
Where have you been?
There,
we were just talking about you this morning.
Is that my usual ringing?
Weren't we, Sally?
I usually want
to. The preparation for it actually begins in December, preparing the lists, getting the tickets, sending them to all the members, and then beginning with the first week in March, the drawings start, and run all the way through to about the third Saturday in August when they have the dinner dance. We've had a band that has been very good. They play all sorts of music, especially 50s music, which is right in the wheelhouse of most of us who remember the 50s music when it came out. Everybody seems to have a good time. It's been very well attended. The participation in terms of buying tickets is also well attended. Quite a number of people who belong to the lodge and people who don't. There are a few people in the lodge who sell tickets to friends, and so the amount of money that's raised is adequate to fund the charity committee for the rest of the year.
Can you hear me now? I don't know if you realize, but my committee started this in November of last year. We've been working all year long, so how about a good round of applause for the committee of the 25-25. I want to thank everyone for coming out and participating in the 25-25 dinner. A big round of applause for the many, many volunteers that put this together. A lot of people, all the people here in the kitchen and the wait staff, all volunteers here at the lodge.
Congratulations to Elks Lodge 1899. 65 years. I will see you the next centennial.
We're here tonight, we're assembling our backpacks, and it's a program that we're initiating using the Elks National Foundation Community Investment Program grant. It's called a Promise Grant. Behind me is all of the volunteers from our lodge that's currently putting the backpacks together, and we will reconvene tomorrow when the kids actually arrive and distribute them. We received $2,500, which is the maximum amount of the Promise Grant. We're utilizing this grant for the first time, initiating a South Kingstown Elks Lodge back to school backpack program. And this is for low-income students from preschool through eighth grade. And we have purchased 100 backpacks. We've purchased supplies for those backpacks, and we plan on distributing those tomorrow. We've got all of the 100 students coming tomorrow to our lodge. We're going to serve refreshments, which will include pizza, ice cream, and some other things, and that's when we'll distribute the backpacks.
Hi, I'm Terry Huff. I just wanted to wish South Kingston Elks a happy 65th birthday.
The Rocksteady Boxing Program actually is a non-contact boxing program for our individuals within the community with Parkinson's disease. The Rock City Boxing Program came to the South County Y. Everybody came in, they treated each other like they knew each other for years, and it was like family. Jerry Gardner, one of our Elks here at the club, decided that an annual fundraiser for Rock City Boxing to support the South County YMCA would help. We put a great event together in September of 2017. We had a nice barbecue outside. We had the Jamestown Community Band, and they donated their time and their services. We also had a magician, and he wanted to be part of the fundraiser as well. Between the magician and Gayamoto, the Rock City Boxers that were here, and all of our coaches, we did a demonstration.
So these are all our Rocksteady Boxing coaches. Everybody give them a hand.
Being a neurological disease, it tends to make you go like this and curl up. And we're trying to open up their chest, keep the shoulders back, strengthen the body, the upper part of the body. Boxing does have some kind of an impact on the neurological system. So the fundraiser in all was a huge success. We did raffles, silent auctions. I can't thank the Elks Lodge of South Kingstown enough for all their help in putting out all this wonderful food, helping us with the silent auctions, the ticket sales, the raffles, everything.
I'm Paul, and I'm proud to say I've been a member of the Lodge for 9 years. Happy anniversary, South Kingstown Lodge.
We can never forget those who came before us.
Fellow brother and sister firefighters, members of the Gray, Love, and the Page families.
Fire service in the town of South Kingstown is filled with a rich history of volunteerism and tradition. I'm Tim Redman, both a member of the Elks and the Volunteer Fire Service in South Kingstown. Members of the South Kingstown Elks have always been eager to show support for our local volunteer firefighters. In fact, quite a few members serve as volunteer firefighters. In the annual Fireman's Parade, members march showing support and appreciation to our local volunteer firefighters. It's nice to see them out there waving their American flags and marching proudly down the road. some Elks members own antique fire apparatus and probably display that. Elks member Fran Sherman is always eager to show her antique car that has been in her family for years.
The Home Wrap crew brings the trailer to spread the word about home maintenance, repair, and assistance program for seniors.
At this particular parade that pays tribute to the PCL Fire Department's 150th anniversary, members of the South Kingstown Elks serve a hot-cooked meal to the firefighters.
The first thing I want to do is talk about our parade marshal. Our parade marshal is sitting over behind you. He's a mentor of mine. He is a World War II veteran. He is past captain of the South Kingstown Police Department, and he is a 70-year member of our organization. So I would like you to all turn, give a round of applause to Captain Danny Purcell.
It's always a nice thing to see the Elks coming out in full support of the fire service.
Happy 65th birthday, South Kingstown Lodge 1899. With love, Amanda O'Hara.
As the chairman of the Elks Soccer Shoot for Lodge 1899, we go ahead and we set up a competition amongst young people between the ages of 5 all the way up to 16. The competition introduces young people to the Elks organization. At the same time, we get involved with our youth. We have boys and we also have girls that compete within the soccer shoot at the same. What this does is it helps them to meet up, keeps them active, and allows them to have a friendly competition amongst each other. We have three different levels that we do for the soccer shoot. We have the lodge, which is a local event. And what this does is it takes those young people for the first time, puts them together, and they compete. The next time that we'll see the group will be in Coventry, which is a state shoot. From there, we will go ahead and select two and move them forward to what's known as the regional event, hosted in New Hampshire. And they're treated very well when they get there. They have all kinds of goodie bags that they're given, things that keep their interest in soccer, keep their interest in the healthy competition that they have going, and keeps them active within the community.
Congratulations, Lodge 1899. My name is Mark Larson.
Eating with the ecosystem.
Eating with the ecosystem has been doing this dinner since 2014. It was the first time we did it because one of our board members, Rodman Sykes, is a member of the Elks Club, and he's been doing community dinners with some of the other nonprofits he's been involved with for many years. And so he rounds up all of his volunteers, friends from the Elks, and they join forces with volunteers from our organization, Eating with the Ecosystem, and we all get in the kitchen together, and we get a wide diversity of local seafood species that's all been donated by local fishermen and seafood dealers. And we spend the day, or a day or two, in the kitchen here at the Elks, cooking it up. And Saturday night at 5 o'clock, about 125 people roll in the door, and we feed them the feast of their lives. All kinds of seafood that they've never tried before. All local, all caught by fishermen right here in our community. And the reason we do this is that the mission of Eating with the Ecosystem is to sort of help appreciate the ecosystems that produce our seafood and the people who depend on them, but also to help people learn to balance their seafood diet so that it matches what the ecosystem is producing.
In the second cross, it's going to include Jonah crab, rice pilaf, fish cakes, fried fish cakes made with sea bass, scallop, and sea robin, grilled lemon pepper monk fish, Italian stuffed squid with homemade marinara sauce. We have some kelp salad and coleslaw.
Rather than just expecting the ecosystem to produce, you know, the one or two species that we're familiar with. So people learn how to eat things like slipper limpets, which we'll be serving tonight, thresher shark, sea robin, we've done scup a bunch of times, monkfish livers, and they love every bite they eat here.
Congratulations, Lodge 1899. Happy birthday, South Kingstown Elks. My name is Michael Hughes.
Hi, everyone. I'm proud to and honored to welcome Grace.
Who... And the Elks have really, really impacted my life in a ton of different ways that are just absolutely incredible. It's called an Elks Scholar Service Trip. It's a compilation of people from all across the country that come together for a week just to serve, just to give back, just to really experience what the Elks is all about.
It is quite appropriate that such a service should be held by the Order of Elks, an organization that is distinctively American, intensely patriotic, and without counterpart.
Hands, salute.
Hi, I'm Rachel. I'd like to wish the South Kingstown Elks Lodge a very happy 65th birthday.
I can't thank our people and even outsiders that aren't Elks enough to pull this off, because it takes many hands. From the deliveries to the prep, you put a sign-up sheet on the wall and people come out of the woodwork to help out. Prepping the turkeys on Monday, vegetables, potatoes on Tuesday, Wednesday, and they're all ready, peeled and mashed, and ready to go on Thursday, and everything's in the oven to heat.
Thanksgiving. Banana coconut, chocolate cream. I think it's about 40 others in the card.
Look at that, it's a perfect piece of pie. It's got your name on it.
The police department, they have quite a ranking structure going on for the Thanksgiving dinners to be passed out to the different municipalities, starting from Captain Joel Chowell, Sergeant Patty Gardner, and right on down the line, and other patrolmen, and they really work hard there. They really work hard to get the job done.
Have a good day, thank you guys.
Mm-hmm. These are members of the South Kingston Elks Lodge, most of them, and what they do is they coordinate putting the meals together to go for the municipalities in North Kingston and all the various towns. The little table where Jim Rush, Dave Schofield, and myself are setting is called Command Central. They're shipping all the containers to the set ends. People that can't get out, prefer to be home, whatever the case may be. And Jim and Dave coordinate where the meals are going and what time they're going to be delivered.
Thank you, young man. You're a good man. Thank you.
This is Sonny right here, but don't tell anybody he's really Santa Claus.
Right, right.
I do.
Well, thank you very much.
Thanksgiving dinner for us.
Santa.
You can have that.
That's Sonny. Sonny does a lot for the Elks. Sonny's there when you need him. He's like a lot of other Elks. They're all around help. They just pitch in with anything. Ryan DeLuca, he is another amazing person. He's a lot of fun. I understand from all the guys in the kitchen.
At first, I started for Elk members only and their family. And I felt there was a need in our community. So around 2007, I started it, opened the doors to the community. This past year, we had 784 meals put together for various police, fire, and people in the community in need.
What it means to me, it's the most rewarding event that could possibly happen at South Kingston Elks Lodge.
Happy 65th anniversary, South Kingston Lodge, 1899.
Hi, I'm Bill Harney. I've been a member of the Elks Lodge for 36 years. I've been on the House for 30 years, House Committee Chairman 28 years.
What are you doing here?
Well, I'm cooking some big flour with some vegetables and baked potato for Friday night supper. Very, very popular at the Elks Lodge. 1-899, by the way.
The fish fry originally started years ago. We've incorporated that with the Friday night supper in the wintertime. Fish is not available. Everybody volunteers and puts out meals for our members and the public. The steak fry is the last Wednesday of every month. It's also a huge revenue for the lodge. Open to the public. Very popular. Very popular. We also do the shrimp fest. We have a bartender's appreciation night. Bar bingo. There's a lot of functions going on in the lounge itself that welcome a lot of people to come down and enjoy it. And they do. It's a fabulous organization. We do a lot of things for the community.
Everyone.
We also host the annual eggnog party for our members. It's Appreciation Day. Our volunteers are very important to us. They're part of the lodge, and without them, we can't make this happen. Our number one goal is for the community and for our lodge. Without the support for the volunteers and the help we have, we wouldn't be able to pull it off.
Hi, I'm Lisa. Happy 65th birthday to the South Kingstown Elks, number 1899.
We're here at the Elks today entertaining the children for the children's Christmas party. And we have Santa Claus and Mrs. Claus arriving, and the fire trucks are going to be arriving at 1 o'clock.
Vixen and Blitzen and all his reindeer are pulling on the rein. Bells are ringing, children singing, all is merry and bright. Hang your stockings and say your prayers, cause Santa Claus comes tonight.
Here comes Santa Claus, here comes Santa Claus, right down Santa Claus Lane.
You all having fun?
He's got a bag that is filled with toys for the boys.
This thing is great.
Hear those sleigh bells, jingle jangle, what a beautiful sight. Jump in bed, cover up your head, Santa Claus comes tonight, tonight. Santa Claus comes tonight. With those holiday greetings and gay happy meetings when friends come to call, it's the happiest season of all. There'll be parties for hosting, marshmallows for toasting, and caroling out in the snow. There'll be scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time of the year. Much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time.
Mm-hmm.